If it can be said that American shooter fanatics seem to be obsessed with World War II or just the modern war era, on the same note, I feel like the Japanese RPG developers or publishers or just those people who really are into those games, on the other hand, they really seem to be infatuated with the Middle Ages and more specifically with the Hundred Years' War. So, just like how the patriotism of World War II era and the dislikable nature of the Nazis fuels the adrenaline rush of American gamers, something about the mysteriousness of female teenage savior Joan of Arc and the mighty talent and skill of the Black Prince seems to invoke a deep sense of intrigue among the Japanese. Whatever the reason, the developer Level 5 decided to make yet another strategy RPG inspired by the historical events of the Hundred Years' War. Joan of Arc was called Jeanne d'Arc in France, and that is the name of this PSP game. However, players interested in this game should not expect a boring history lesson of the long and bloody loyal feud between England and France. After all, this is a Japanese game, and the Japanese deeply prefer fantasy over realism. So, the game mixes a bit of history with a lot of fantasy and plot twists that ultimately make you fall in love with the game's writing. Once the game starts explaining all the little tidbits about the story, players will no longer be turned off by the fact that the English army is mainly composed of demons. Slowly, as the story unfolds through countless cutscenes, by the 6 hours or so, the story moves kind of slow. You'll be drawn into this world where historical facts are accurate, such as the Dauphin was crowned as King of France with John's help, just as the game shows. But where the presentation is nothing but fantasy. The story is by far the best part of the game. It's polished, well-written, and just plain amazing to see it unfold. I do have one complaint, though, and that is that the story is presented with countless amount of loading screens, and a lot of the scenes in the game are unnecessary dialogue. Hopefully, though, the presentation style helps you overlook the loading screens. Most of the cutscenes are presented with text boxes and in-game motions, but the French accents are carried over to the written text so well that it's hard not to fall in love with the game's presentation style. I mean, all the European accents in this game are really done well, the voice acting. Not to mention the 3D graphic engine for this game is rather beautiful. It's not state-of-the-art, but it carries the atmosphere and the tone of the game quite nicely, especially when the game starts to have darker themes. Oftentimes, you'll be presented to an anime sequence with full voice acting. The voice acting is excellent in this game, and I honestly cannot remember a video game that perfects the French and English accents like that, especially the medieval ones, so well. The anime cutscenes are really great to watch. It's just disappointing that there's so few of the anime cutscenes. The gameplay is your regular strategy RPG fanfare. You take turns moving your characters in a grid-based map and assign different commands. If you attack someone from the side or the back, you do more damage. If you attack them from higher terrain, you have better accuracy and do more damage. All typical SRPG stuff that you're used to. But the game is very user-friendly and it's easy to get into gameplay. There are some nuances to this game, like the sun/star/moon system, like a rock-paper-scissors system, that you assign to each character. The skill assigning and the burning ring deal, but it's pretty typical by the end. The combat can be a bit monotonous. Having different kinds of characters is cool, but the maximum amount of skills you can assign to a character is 6. And that's just not enough, and it's not as fun as having, say, like 10 skills. The level design is mostly pretty decent, but some are tedious as hell. The game limits you in the amount of turns you can take. For example, use over 21 turns in one map and it's automatic game over. So that can make you feel a bit rushed when you're playing, but really it's not the fact that they're linear, but the fact that some levels are so narrow and so long that it's just downright boring. The one cool thing about the levels, though, is that each level will have different conditions for victory. That was always refreshing and fun. One forgiving thing about this game is that it gives you opportunities to grind, lots of them. Some stages will allow you to revisit and fight random monsters for experience and loot, and that is always nice. Some free combat stages are unlockable to test your wits and skill, such as the Colosseum stage. They also hold great replay value. However, some of these free combat stages are the ones most guilty of terrible level design. Lastly, if there is one thing I absolutely hate about the game, it's binding skills. After quite a number of hours playing the game, you will be given the option to combine and mix certain skills to make a new skill. For example, you can mix HP plus 10 and another HP plus 10 to make HP plus 20. Or you can combine Flash Strike with Preemptive Strike to make a counter. I thought this was a cool feature. But not when combining two skills can take up 20 seconds each time. I remember spending an entire hour doing nothing but binding skills because I had a lot of items to combine and I didn't want to spend money buying items I wanted. Oh yeah, that's another thing. Even if you do have a lot of money, most stores in this game are worthless and hardly ever sell anything that's worth it. It's better to win loot from battles and bind your own skills than shop for them because the stores really don't carry anything that you'd want. Overall, the game, gameplay-wise, is a mediocre SRPG experience, but it is saved by the incredible story that fuses history and fantasy ingeniously. The story is truly the saving grace of the game, and when you get to the last boss battle, which is one of the most epic SRPG battles I've encountered, I bet you tend to overlook the menace and the game's of the game's gameplay, and remember John the Ark as one of the greatest SRPGs to come to a handheld system.